Hi guys, Virtus Education here with episode 4 of the HTML web programming tutorial series, and in today's episode we're going to be finally adding some content into our website. Now for the most part what I'm going to be teaching you is showing you how to get some very basic text into your website to use as a foundation. So before we do go ahead and start making some text, there is a few different things we need to know. We can't simply just type text into our website willy-nilly. We're going to need special tags for different types of text. So as you can see here, I've got a few examples of some different types of text here, such as I'm using paragraphs, I'm using the span tags, I'm even using line breaks, but we'll get into this a little bit later. So let's just go ahead and start randomly typing some code into our website to see what it does. So if I just keep typing in a bit of code here, just a little bit of gobbledygook rolling my face across the keyboard and all that, if I go ahead and press Control S, it's all just gonna put it all onto one line, which isn't necessarily what we've got. And even if we just go ahead and like put spaces in between it, similar to this, it's gonna give us the same exact result each and every time. So the way the browser works is that it's something called white space insensitive. Having said that, whenever it's looking at your code, it ignores any empty space like this, which is usually known as white space. Typically, you know, in your IDE, it's gonna be a white background. So no matter how much extra space here, the browser's just going to ignore it and just put everything in line, pretty much just like that. So we can actually play around with a few different tags to pretty much get you the result that you want. And the tags that I'll be touching up on in today's episode include paragraph tags, span tags, line break tags, bold and italic tags. There's also a whole bunch of stuff that I'm going to leave you in a resource page to check out too. So let's go ahead and start off by creating a paragraph. So just create your very first paragraph. Just go ahead and create a P tag somewhat like this. Just open bracket, close bracket P, and then also you're going to need to close this as well. So just pretty much do what we usually do, where we just put this little forward slash in here. So once we got our paragraph tags, we can start typing in whatever we want. So for the most part, we're going to be using this page to describe ourselves. I'm going to say, hello, my name is Luke, and this is just a very simple test website. Now, if I go ahead and press save, and I go ahead and create another paragraph, you're going to see that it's going to be on a separate line. Hello, this is someone else talking, and then just gonna pretty much end it off there, doing the same thing for the paragraph, the closing tag once again, making sure that I close it off. So if I go ahead and save this, you're gonna see that it pretty much has gone ahead and formatted this in the way as if it was a paragraph, and you can see there's plenty of space in between. However, for most people, you know, this is going to be a little bit too much space in between. So what we can actually do is go ahead and use something called span tags. This is essentially just used for text. So I'll just go ahead and type span, press end, close it off and type something in here, line 3, and then it's going to copy and paste this a couple of times. It's going to go Control C, Control V, and save that, and let's take a look at what it's done. So it's once again gone back to case insensitive. However, what we actually need in between this is something called a line break. Now, these line breaks are essentially just going to make whatever text it is go onto the line directly beneath, and there won't be this crazy space in between like there is in paragraphs. So to create a line break, all you gotta do is just type open bracket br forward slash like this. Now certain tags you don't necessarily need two of them. In the case of the line break, you don't. So let's just go ahead and play around with this. So I'm just gonna make a couple more real quickly. And just like that, you know, I'm just going to go ahead and copy and paste my code. It's definitely something that you're going to want to do whenever you're programming. whether it's software or even websites, you're going to want to copy and paste your code just for the sake of saving time. So if I go ahead and press refresh here, you can see we've now got a whole bunch of different text which has gone down and there's a break in between it. Now there's also a couple of different things we can apply to this, like little modifiers. For example, if we wanted to, we can make certain text bold, we can make it italic, and so on and so forth. So let's just go ahead and show you how we can make certain parts of it bold. So I'm just going to go ahead and try and make this text here inside the paragraph where it says Luke bold. So to do that, what you got to do is just make some tags, and we're going to be using strong tags. Now, whenever you're making something for bold or italic, you want to make sure you're encapsulating pretty much only what you want to be bold inside of it. So for example, if I go ahead and do this, closing off the bold tag here, and you will see that Luke is now bold. We can also do pretty much the same thing for italic. Usually the tag is called EM for emphasized. So I'm just going to go ahead and emphasize simple. So just pretty much use tags, one to open it and one to close it, similar to the previous stuff. If I go ahead and press save, and you can see that it is now being, emphasized. So that's pretty much everything you need to know about making some very basic text and putting it into your website. Feel free to check out the resources page for this episode, which I've left in the description below. Feel free to write up some stuff about yourself, making some little descriptions, multiple paragraphs, multiple lines, use line breaks, and so on and so forth. And yeah, it's pretty much everything for this tutorial. So thanks for watching, comment, like, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next episode. Goodbye.